Chaksurmilitanyena tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swami Tinamine Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Precharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Desatarine Vancha Kaupatarabhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasade Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're recounting the activities of Ajamila and how he was to be taken by the Yamadutas to Yamaraj for punishment, but the Vishnudutas came and would not allow them to take Yamaraj, would not allow the Yamadutas to take Ajamil. So the Yamadutas had never been stopped before, and it was a great surprise to them to be restricted by the all-powerful and all-attractive Vishnu Dutas.
Yamaduta 以前从来没有遇到过这样的情况，因为以前从来没有人阻止过他，他如今现在被这个有力量的Vishnu Dutas给阻止了。
So the Vishnu Dutas challenged that the Yamaduras were not aware of what are the principles of religion. So the Vishnudutas are explaining to the Yamadutas about the highest principle of religion.
So Vishnuduta 就给 Yamaduta 讲授最高的宗教原则.
And so that they explained that a person may be able to neutralize, to take away the reactions of his sinful life if he does some austerity or charity.
他说如果一个人 他犯下了最严重的这个罪行的话，但是如果他做了一些苦行和忏悔的话，
yeah, if a person does some pious activities, then it can take away the effects of his sins.
如果他们做了一些虔诚的活动的话，可以弥补他们的罪恶，
but it cannot take away the desire for sin.
但是不能消除他们罪恶，内心罪恶的欲望。
The desire for sin will still remain in the heart of the person.
这种想要从事罪恶活动的欲望仍然保持在一个人的内心之中。
But if that person serves the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord, then he gets freed from all that contamination.
但是如果这样的人他服务过至尊主的莲花足的话，他可以去除这样的内心的污染。So
this is an important principle about devotional service.
这是奉爱服务的一个非常重要的原则。Right?
If somebody does devotional service, then he gets immediately free from sinful desires.
如果一个人从事过奉爱服务的话，他可以立即驱除内心的从事罪恶活动的污染。
Everybody has sinful desires in the material world.
在这个物质世界，每一个人都有这种从事活动的欲望，罪恶活动的欲望。
So everybody in this material world is more or less sinful.
因此，在这个物质世界上的人或多或少都是罪恶的。
But pure, if you do pure bhakti, if you do pure devotion, then it's without any material desire.
但如果他做纯粹的奉献服务的话，就没有物质的欲望。
So if a person does pure devotion, he won't have any material desires, and there won't be any sinful reactions.
如果一个人从事纯粹的奉献服务，他不会有从事罪恶活动的欲望，也不会有罪恶的反应。
Material desires will be stopped.
物质的愿望将会停止。
But a person may do austerity, he may do charity, and he may do penance, and so that may help him to get free from sin for some time.
然而，一个人如果从事苦行、忏悔或者布施，他，但是他得花上一些时间才能去除他内心的这些，罪恶。
But the material desire will again come in his heart.
而且物质的欲望会再一次出现在他的内心之中。
And again he will act sinfully, and he will bring suffering on himself.
同时他会再一次犯罪并经受痛苦。
So the Vishnu Duras give an example. They say, just like fire burns dry grass to ashes.
维什努杜塔给出了一个例子，就像干的这个草化为灰烬。
So the holy name of the Lord, when people chant it, even though they don't know, or they may know, they may not know, but when they chant, it will burn to ashes all of their sinful reactions.
同样的，当一个人唱诵主的圣名，无论他是有意的唱诵或者无意的唱诵。都将把他的罪恶活动的反应化为灰烬。
Just like we know fire, it doesn't matter if the little child puts their hand in the fire, they're going to get burned.
不管一个小孩子他是否知道这个火的威力，他只要把手放在火里面，他就会被烧着。
The child didn't know the fire would burn, but he still gets burned.
这个小孩也不知道这个火是怎样，但是他还是会被烧到。
So if you have a field with a lot of dry grass, and you set fire to it, maybe an old man, the old man knows about the fire, but there's a child there, and the child doesn't know about the fire. So if the child sets fire, the grass will burn. Doesn't matter if he knows or not.
就像在一大片的干草地那里，一个长者知道这个火的力量，这个小孩子或者旁边还有一个小孩子，他不知道。但是这个不知道的小孩子如果点燃这一片火的，点燃这一片大草的大田地的这些干草的话，这一片田地的草就会被燃烧起来。
So chanting Hare Krishna works the same way.You may know or you may not know, but still you'll get the benefit and you'll get free of sinful reactions.
唱诵 Hare Krishna 曼陀罗也是有同样的道理在这个里面。无论你知道或者不知道唱诵 Hare Krishna 曼陀罗的力量，只要你唱诵，所有的罪恶活动都会被燃烧成灰烬。
And Vishnu Duras give another example.
维什努都塔给出了另外一个例子。
They say just like a person may take a medicine, and he doesn't know about how powerful the medicine is.
一个人他举了一个例子，就是一个人他开始吃一个药，但是他不知道这个药的疗效到底是怎样。
But the medicine will act, even though he doesn't know about how powerful it is.
即便他不知道这个药有多大的力量，只要他吃的话，就会有，就会产生作用。
The power of the medicine doesn't depend on the person knowing anything about the medicine.
因为药的疗效不取决于病人对这个药知道多少。
In the same way, person may not know about the value of chanting the holy name, but still, you get the benefit.
同样的，一个人或许不知道唱诵圣名的价值，但是他只要唱诵的话，就会有益处。
So Prabhupada talks about how in the Western countries, Hare Krishna movement is spreading, and people are appreciating the power of the chanting Hare Krishna mantra.
圣帕帕德在这里举出例子，就是讲到 Hare Krishna 运动在西方的时候受到人们很多的欣赏，即便他们不知道这个力量，但是他们仍受益，仍被吸引。
And Prabhupada writes about one man he met was one man, he was a big scholar in a university, and he said the scholar was very appreciative. He understood how Prabhupada was turning people who were hippies and addicted to drugs, and Prabhupada was making them into Vaishnavas.
圣帕帕德在这里举到了一个很大的学者，他是一个大学里面的教授。他非常欣赏 Hare Krishna 的这个运动，他亲眼看到很多嬉皮士和沉迷于麻醉品的这些年轻人，在唱诵了 Hare Krishna 之后，变成了纯洁的奉献者。
And when they became devotees, they became pure servants of Krishna, and they worked for the benefit of humanity to help people.
当他们成为奉献者之后，他们自愿成为主 Krishna 的仆人。以及成为善于想要帮助整个人类社会的人。
So Prabhupada explains, he said, before they met Prabhupada, before they met Hare Krishna, they didn't know anything about Krishna, they didn't know about the Hare Krishna mantra.
他说，当这些嬉皮士在见到 Hare Krishna, 在遇见圣帕帕德之前，他们完全不知道这个 Hare Krishna 是什么，也完全不理解，也不知道圣帕帕德是谁。
But now they've become pure Vaishnavas and they're chanting the Maha Mantra.
但是他们却现在成为纯洁的奉献者，而且开始唱诵 Hare Krishna Maha Mantra.
And they've completely given up all of their bad habits, the drugs and the meat eating and the intoxication.
而且他们现在放弃了所有的不好的习惯，比如吃肉、服用麻醉品、赌博、非法性生活等。
So this is proof of the power of chanting Hare Krishna.
这就是唱诵 Hare Krishna 的有力的证明。
And it's supported by this verse from the Srimad Bhagavatam.
而这里的圣典波迦瓦坛也证明了这一点。
So somebody may know or they may not know about the power of chanting Hare Krishna, but if they chant, it will act.
有一些人或许知道或许不知道唱诵 Hare Krishna, 但是他们只要一唱诵就会起作用。
And people will get purified from chanting.
人们会从唱诵之中获得净化。
Just like when a person is sick, they take a medicine and they'll feel the effect of the medicine. They didn't know about what the medicine was, but the medicine acts.
就像一个生病的人，他只要吃了药之后，他就会感觉到凉，会感觉到好一些。即便他不知道这个药是什么，药里面是什么，他只要吃药就会产生作用。
And he may not even know that he's taking the medicine. He may take the medicine unknowingly, but still the medicine will act.
或许他吃药还是一种无意识的吃药的活动，就是他根本不知道自己吃药了，但是这个药还是会在他身上起作用。
So Sukadeva Goswami is describing this pastime of Ajamila. He's talking to Maharaj Parikshit. So he tells Maharaj Parikshit that he should understand the principles of devotional service.
圣 Sukadeva Goswami 给 Parikshit Maharaj 讲述了这个历史的事情。 他告诉 Maharaj Parikshit， 我们应该了解奉爱服务的原则。
So he said that the Vishnu Duras they released Ajamil. Excuse me.
Vishnu Duta 把阿加米勒给解救了出来。
So Ajamila had been tied up by the Yamaduras. They were planning to take him for punishment to Yamaraj, but the Vishnu Duras released him.
Yamaduta 把阿加米勒准备逮起来带到 Yamaraj 那里去，但是呢 ，Vishnu Duta 把阿加米勒给解救了出来。
And they describe everything about devotional service, and they presented everything with good reasons and arguments to defeat the Yamadutas.
而且他在这里陈述了很好的原因和理由，而且还击败了 Yamaduta.
So after the Yamadutas had heard everything from the Vishnu Duras, they went back to see Lord Yamaraj.And they told him everything that had happened.
当亚玛都塔听到了维什努都塔给他们说的这一切之后，他们这个时候就准备回到亚玛拉吉那里去，给亚玛拉吉讲述这里所发生的一切。
So usually the Yamadutas, they're very powerful, and nobody can ever interfere with them in whatever they do. But this time, they were defeated.
通常情况下，亚玛都塔非常有力量，他们在任何地方不会受到阻拦。但是这一次，他们被击败了。
They were saying Ajamila is sinful and he should be taken to Yamaraj for punishment.
他们认为这个阿加米勒是有罪的，所以应该去到 Yamaraj 那里接受惩罚。
But the Vishnu Duta said no, he's free of all of his sins.
但是维什努都塔说不。他已经免于了所有的罪恶。
So they come back to Yamaraj and they tell Yamaraj everything which happened.
所以他们回到了 Yamaraj 那里去，向他描述了所发生的一切。
And Ajamila, now he was free from his fear because he'd seen the Yamaduras. He was very afraid of the Yamaduras, and he knew the Yamaduras were going to arrest him and take him for punishment.So he was very afraid of them. But when he saw that they're gone and that he got free of the Yamaduras, he was so grateful that he offered his obeisances to the Vishnu Duras.
Yamaduta 这个时候也脱离了恐惧，因为在这之前他看到了 Yamaduta, 阿加米勒在这个时候看到了 在这之前看到了 Yamaduta,他感觉到非常恐惧，因为亚玛都塔正要把他带到去亚玛拉杰那里接受惩罚，但是维什努都塔来了，所以呢，他不仅脱离了恐惧，而且向维什努都塔顶拜，他非常感激维什努都塔。
Yeah, he saw that the Vishnu Duras had saved him from going to Yamaraj, so he was very grateful to them.
阿加米勒非常感激维什努都塔，因为他亲眼看到了维什努都塔。把他从亚玛都塔那里解救出来。
So Srila Prabhupada explains, he said, Vaishnavas, they're also Vishnu Duras, because their duty is to carry out the orders of Lord Krishna.
圣帕帕德在这里解释说，每一个 Vaishnava 也应该是 Vaishnava 也是 Vishnu Duta, 因为他们在执行 Krishna 的命令。
So Lord Krishna is very...eager to save all the conditioned souls in the material world.
主 Krishna 非常渴望想拯救在这个物质世界里的堕落的受条件限制的灵魂。
He doesn't like to see all these conditioned souls have to go to Yamaraj and be punished.
主 Krishna 非常不希望看到这些受条件限制的灵魂被带到 Yamaraj 那里去接受惩罚。
So he tries to save these conditioned souls to help them understand what their real duty is.
因此，主 Krishna 想拯救这些堕落的灵魂，想告诉他们真正的职责是什么。
So if somebody is fortunate, then they get the mercy of a Vishnu Duda or some other Vaishnava.
如果他足够幸运，如果一个人足够幸运的话，他会得到一位 Vaishnava 或者 Vishnu Duda 的仁慈。
And by their mercy, then they go back home, back to Godhead.
借由他们的仁慈，他们这些受条件限制的灵魂可以回归守神，回归家园。
So Ajamila, he was trying to say something to the Vishnu Dutas. He wanted to say something to them, but then the Vishnu Dutas, they just disappeared.
Ajamila 正想跟 Vishnu Duta 说一点什么，但是呢 ，Vishnu Duta 立刻的从他眼前消失了。
So sinful people, people who are very sinful, they can die at any time.
那些非常罪恶的人可以在任何时候就离开躯体。
Especially when they're not clean in their habits.
尤其是当他们有不洁的这个品质的时候。
Or if they offend the devotees and the Vaishnavas.
或者他们冒犯了一位奉献者或者 Vaishnava.
And if they eat anything, they have the habit to eat anything, anytime, any place, then they can die at any time and any place.
或者他什么都吃，而且在不择食，也不选择地点，什么都不选择的人，他就是说他什么都吃的人，对于这些人来说，他们也是很有可能在某一刻就离开躯体。
In Kali Yuga, people were supposed to live for 100 years.
在卡利年代，人们通常可以活100年。
But,
应该想着应该是可能要活100年。
But because as Kali Yuga goes on, that duration of life will become less and less.
随着卡利年代往前不断的推，往前不断的走，人们的寿命也不断的缩减。
As Kali Yuga goes on, if you be, when you become 40 or something, then you'll be considered very old.
在一就是在。在卡利年代再往前再走一点的时候，人们的寿命如果在40岁的时候，那个时候都算是很长寿的。
So Ajamila was lucky because he got free from his sinful reactions, so his lifetime was extended more.
阿加米勒是很幸运的，因为他本来就应该马上要死去，但是现在他免于了这些罪恶反应，他的生命得到了延长。
So he was actually meant to die at that time, but the Vishnu Duras came and they saved him.
他本来在那个时候就应该死去了，但是 Vishnu Duta 来了，帮拯救了他。
So when they saw Ajamila was trying to say something to them, then they disappeared because they didn't want him to glorify them. They wanted Ajamila to glorify the Supreme Lord.
当维什努都塔看到阿加米勒想要说什么的时候，维什努都他们就离开了，因为维什努都塔不希望阿加米勒去荣耀他，他希望这个阿加米勒去荣耀主维什努。
So because he got free of his sins, so he's ready to glorify the Supreme Lord.
因为他已经免除了一切罪恶的活动，所以呢，他现在可以荣耀主了。
Of course, this is stated in the Bhagavad Gita that you have to get free of sins before you can engage properly in devotional service.
这一点在《博迦梵歌》也得到了确证。除非一个人能免除罪恶活动，否则他无法坚定的做奉献服务。
So the Vishnu Duras, they made Ajamila understand devotional service.
Vishnu Duta.威士努都塔令阿加米勒意让阿加米勒意识到了奉献服务。
So now he's very eager to go back home back to Godhead.
现在他也非常渴望想回归家园，回归守身。
So when the Vishnu Duras disappeared, then it increased Arjamila's eagerness to glorify the Supreme Lord.
当维什努都塔消失了之后，这也增加了阿加米勒想要荣耀主的愿望。
Because he could feel the separation from the Lord and the Lord's devotees.
因为这个时候他能感觉到与至尊主以及主的奉献者的分离之情。
So he, Ajamila had heard the Vishnu Duras and Yama Duras talk to each other.
阿加米勒听了维什努都塔和亚玛都塔之间的对话。
So he could understand how the religious principles are different in different modes of nature.
他可以理解物质自然属性下的这些宗教原则。
But he could also understand that there's transcendental religious principles.
同时他还理解了这些超然的宗教原则。
Right, this is, and that is about the relationship between the Lord and the living entities.
而这个超然的宗教原则是主这些生物和主之间的关系。
So Ajamila, because he'd been hearing about the glorification of the chanting of the holy name and the Lord's qualities, so he'd become a good devotee. It helped him to become, to restore, to change himself and to become a good devotee.
Ajamila 还聆听了至尊主的圣名、品质和品质名声的这些荣耀，因此他转变为一位纯粹的奉献者。
And this way, then he began to remember how his past sinful activities, and he felt very sinful. He regretted that he'd done so many bad things.
同时，他还回忆起过去他所从事的那些罪恶活动，为他所从事的这些罪恶活动感到忏悔不已。
So, the Vedas deal the Vedic literature. They're mainly concerned with the three modes of nature.
韦达经主要讨论的是物质自然三属性。
So you can gradually, people may follow the Vedas and gradually come to the spiritual platform.
人们可以通过韦达经逐渐的来到这种超然的层面。
But if we get attached to the Vedic principles, then you may never come to the spiritual platform.
但是如果一个人很依附韦达经的话，他就无法超越，就一直会停留在这个物质的层面。
Therefore, Krishna told Arjuna just to do devotional service.
因此 ，Krishna 跟 Arjuna 说，仅仅去做奉献服务。
Devotional service means transcendental religion.
奉献服务意味着超然的宗教。
People think.That religion should be done for material profit. That's not transcendental.
人们认为这个宗教就是物质的益，为了物质的益处，但是这并不是超然的。
Right? Most people, materialistic people, they're interested in their material life.
大多数人他们在意的是他们的物质生活。
But if somebody is interested in spiritual life, they have to develop an interest in transcendental religion.
但如果他们在意灵性的生活的话，他们应该了解这些灵性的宗教原则。
This is called the Bhagavat religion or transcendental religion.
这个被称为 Bhagavat宗教或者。超然的宗教原则。
And it teaches how the Lord and the living entity are related to each other. The Lord is the master, and the living entity is the servant.
超然的宗教原则讲述的是主和生物之间的关系。主是主人，生物是主的仆人。
And the living entity's duty is to surrender to the Lord.
生物的职责是臣服于主。
So when we do devotional service, then one is completely satisfied. You feel completely satisfied, freed from all material desires.
当一个人从事奉献服务的时候，他不仅能得到彻底的满足，而且能免于所有的物质欲望。
So this happened to Ajamila, because he'd been chanting his son's name. He'd been chanting the holy name.
这样的事情就发生，这个层面就发生在阿加米勒的身上，因为他已经开始唱诵主的圣名。
So Ajamila then remembered his past sinful activities.
阿加米勒开始回忆起他过去的罪恶活动。
And he began to lament how he'd done so many sins in the past.
他非常的悲伤，为他所过去从事的这么多的罪恶活动感觉到悲伤。
So Ajamila he wanted to glorify the Lord and the name and the fame and the pastimes of the Lord.
阿加米勒想荣耀主的名字、名声以及逍遥时光。
So Ajamila, he could understand he was a servant of his senses.
Ajamila 可以，他说他是这个感官的仆人。
He understood. He said, I'm so fallen. I allowed myself to become so degraded. Initially, I was a Brahman. I was a qualified Brahmana, but I've become so degraded. I fell down from my position.
阿加米勒说，我是多么的堕落，我从一位婆罗门的位置上 Brahmana 的位置上堕落了下来。
And instead I've given children in the womb of a prostitute woman.
而且我竟然在一个妓女的子宫之中繁衍后代。
So in the Vedic culturePeople who are born in a good family, like a Brahmana family, they will never have a relationship with a low-class woman.
在这个伟大的年代，一位出生在高等阶层的人，比如说 Brahmana, 他绝对不能和低等的阶层的这些女性有往来。
So at the time of a marriage, the people will look at the horoscope of the boy and the girl.And they will consider if their horoscopes are suitable.
人们在那个时候是会通过占星看男孩和女孩的这个占星图、天宫图，看他们是否能够在一起，是否合适。
Yeah, when they look at the astrological chart, they can see who is actually a Brahmana and who's Kshatriya, who's Vaishya, who's Sudra.
通过这个占星图，他们了解到底谁是 Brahmana, Kshatriya 和 Vaishya.
And they can see the qualities, which mode of nature they're influenced by.
他们通过这个占星图去了解他们到底受哪一种品质的影响最多。
So if you have like a boy who's a Brahmana and a girl who's a Sudra, it's not a good match.
如果男孩是 Brahmana, 女孩是一个 Sudra, 这两者在一起结合并不好。
The married life will be miserable for both the man and the woman.
这两者在一起的婚姻生活不仅对男孩和对女孩来说都是会非常痛苦的。
Right, the boy should marry a girl who's of his same nature and character.
男孩和女孩应该在同一个阶层结婚，或者说他们有彼此有相同的天性会比较好。
Well, of course, this is a materialistic calculation, but it's according to the Vedas.
当然，这是一种物质的考量和计算，他们也是根据伟达经的。
But then Prabhupada says, if the boy and the girl are devotees, then they don't have to do this.They don't have to worry about that.
然而，圣帕帕德在这里说，如果一个男孩和女孩都是奉献者的话，就不必要考虑这些事情。
A devotee is transcendental.
奉献者是超然的。
So in a marriage between devotee, the boy and the girl, If they're both devotees, then you should be very happy together.
如果男孩和女孩都是奉献者，他们的婚姻在一起会非常的快乐。
So Ajamila, you know, he'd married, he'd got involved with this prostitute woman, and he was a brahmana, so he could understand it was very sinful.
Ajamila, 他理解到他作为一个他曾经是一个婆罗门，但是后来又和一个妓女在一起，他认为这是他理解到自己是非常罪恶的。
So Ajamila condemns himself. He said, "I acted so sinfully. I've degraded all of my family."
阿加米勒说，我这么作恶多端，践踏了家族。
He said, "I gave up. I had a good wife. She was chaste and she was beautiful. She was a young woman, and I gave her up to go and have sex with a prostitute."
阿加米勒说，我竟然抛弃了我这个贞洁、美丽、年轻的好妻子，和一个堕落的妓女在一起。
And this prostitute was drinking, accustomed to drinking wine. She liked to always be intoxicated.
而且这个妓女特别喜欢喝酒，吸食麻醉品。
So Ajamila said, "I was so stupid." He said, "I'm so fallen."
阿加米勒在这里非常自责地说，我这么太愚蠢了，我太堕落了。
So when one is becoming a pure devotee, one will think like this. He will regret his past sins.
当一个人是一个纯粹的奉献者的时候，他会为他过去的这些罪恶活动感觉到忏悔。
So when we take up devotional service by the grace of Krishna and the spiritual master, first thing we should do is regret our past sinful life.
当我们借着主和灵性导师的仁慈提升到奉爱服务的层面上时候，我们第一个要做的事情就是追悔，就是忏悔过去的罪行。
And this will help us to advance in spiritual life.
这会帮助我们在灵性的生活中进步。
By the mercy of the Vishnu Dutas, Ajamila now had the chance to become a good devotee.
由于 Vishnu Dutta 的仁慈，阿加米勒这个时候成为一个好的奉献者。
And the duty of the good devotee is to regret his past sinful life.
一个好的奉献者的职责就是忏悔以前的罪恶活动。
Right. Sinful life means things like illicit sex, intoxication, meat eating, and gambling.
罪恶活动意味着非法性生活，吸食麻醉品，吃肉，赌博。
So it's not enough that we just give up the bad habits, but we should regret that we ever did these bad habits in the past.
人不仅应该摒弃这些罪恶的活动，而且还应该为过去所从事的这些罪恶活动感觉到忏悔。
So this is the meaning of real devotion.
这是真正的奉献服务的意义。
So Ajamila is describing about his own situation. He said, "My father and mother were old, and they had no other son to take care of them."
阿加米勒描述了他现在的状态，他说，我的父母都已经很年迈，没有其他的儿子照顾他们。
And Ajamila said, "I didn't take care of them. I let them live only with so much difficulty. I gave them so much difficulty."
而且我也没有照料好他们，我只是让他们艰难度日。
And then I just left them in that condition with nobody to take care of them.
我把他们留在那样的一个处境之艰难的处境之中，我并没有很好的照顾他们。
So in the Vedic culture, people are supposed to take care of old people, women, children, cows, and brahmanas.
在伟大的文明之中，人们是有责任照顾 brahmana, 老人、妇人、母牛和儿童。
But because Ajamila had been associating with the prostitute, he gave up all his duties.
因为阿加米勒和一个妓女联姻，所以他抛弃了所有这些职责。
So Ajamila could understand he was really very fallen.
因此阿加米勒觉得自己非常非常的堕落。
And Ajamila said, actually he said, because I did so many bad things, I'm so sinful, I should have gone to hell.
阿加米勒还说，因为我做了这么多的错事，我确实应该去到地狱。
I broke all the religious principles. I meant to suffer a lot of misery.
我打破了这么多的宗教原则，我应该去承受痛苦。
So then Ajamila asked himself, he said, maybe, was this just a dream? Or did it really happen? What I saw, was it real? Did I really see these Yamadutas? Or was it just a dream I was having?
Ajamila 这个时候就困惑了。我到底是看到了梦，我到底是在梦到了他们，还是说这是现实？我真的看到了一些面目狰狞的这些亚玛杜塔。
I saw these men with ropes in their hands, and they were coming to arrest me and drag me away.
我看到了这些面目狰狞的人，他们逮捕了我，把我逮了起来，然后想把我带走。
Where did they go? Where did those men go? Those horrible, frightening people.
这些长得很可怕的人，他们到底去了哪里呢？
And what about those four liberated, very beautiful persons? Where have they gone?
而这四个非常解脱的，而且非常俊美的人，他们又去了哪里呢？
They came and they released me. I was being arrested by the horrible men.And they released me, and they got me free.
我被这些面目狰狞的人给逮捕了起来，但是这四位非常美丽的人，他们拯救了我。他们去到了哪里呢？
They saved me from going to hell.
他们把我从地狱之中拯救了出来。
The hellish planets are at the bottom of the universe.
地狱星宿位于整个宇宙的下半部分。
And Ajamila knew that these people, these horrible-looking people, they come from that place in the bottom of the universe.
Ajamila 也知道这些长得很可怕的人，他们是从这个宇宙的底部来的。
So Ajamila describes. He said, "I'm certainly very unfortunate. I'm very sinful, very fallen."
阿加米勒理解到，我肯定是恶贯满盈，罪恶至极。
But somehow, because of my previous spiritual activities, before I was fallen, I was a good person, I was a good brahmana. So, because of when I was a good person, I was able to see these four people who came to rescue me.
尽管如此，由于我以前的这些灵性活动，我看到了这四位崇高的人物来拯救我。
So I feel very happy just because of their visit that they came to rescue me.
我非常非常的高兴，非常高兴他们来拯救。
Because Ajamila had been very pure when he was a young man.And he had associated with devotees and brahmanas.
因为阿加米勒在以前是一个很纯洁的婆罗门，他经常和奉献者和 brahmana 联谊。
So because of that pious activity when he was young, that's how he gave the name Narayana to his son. When he had a son by the prostitute woman, he gave the son's name as Narayana.
因为他有这样他以前的这些虔诚的活动，所以他才能给自己的儿子以 Narayana 的这个名字命名。
And Ajamila also understands, he said, this was because the Lord in my heart inspired me to give that name to my son.
而且阿加米勒也知道，这一定是至尊主在我的内心启示了我，让我给这个名字给我的儿子。
Because Krishna is in the heart,And if anybody ever does service for him, then Krishna never forgets that person.
因为 Krishna 在每一个人的心中，如果以前如果有任何人做过什么的以前的一些奉爱服务的话，主一定不会忘记他所做的服务。
So Krishna within the heart gave Ajamila the chance to give that name Narayana to his son.
因此主在内心给予阿加米勒机会，启发他，让他给自己的小儿子命名为 Narayana。
And so Ajamila would call Narayana, he chant the name of the Lord many, many times, calling his son.
因此阿加米勒很多次的呼唤 Narayana, 呼唤他的小儿子的名字。
And because he'd been calling the name, he got free from all of his sins.
因为他呼唤了主的名字，所以他从所有的罪恶活动、罪恶之中得到了拯救。
This is the mercy of Krishna.
这就是主 Krishna 的仁慈。
By the mercy of Krishna, you get the seed of devotion.
通过主 Krishna 的仁慈，我们得到了奉爱服务的种子。
And that association saves the devotee from the fear of going to hell.
而这样的奉献服务能拯救奉献者免于去到地狱。
So that's why when in Krishna consciousness, devotees get initiated, take away their karmic name and get a name for the soul.
这就是我们 Krishna 知觉之中，我们会给奉献者一个灵性的名字，去掉他这个物质的这个名字。
So it's important at the time of initiation the name is changed.
因此在启迪的时候名字改变是很重要的。
It gives people a chance to remember Krishna at the time of death.
给一个他能够在临死之前记忆起主 Krishna 机会。
So Ajamila is lamenting, he said, he's appreciating thatIf I hadn't have done devotional service before, when I was a young man, then how could I have gotten the opportunity to chant the holy name?
阿加米勒又开始这种自责或思考，要不是我以前从事过奉献服务，我怎么能在死亡之际喊出至尊主的名字呢？圣名呢？
Because I was supposed to die, I was getting ready to die, and I chanted the holy name of the Lord.
我本来在那个时候就应该死了，但是我唱诵了至尊主的圣名。
And at the same time, I'm a dirty person who lives, sinful person living with a prostitute. How could I chant the holy name of the Lord? It could only be because of my past devotional service.
像我这样罪恶肮脏的，而且又和一个妓女在一起的人，我怎么能唱诵主的圣名呢？这一定是我过去所从事的奉献服务所导致的。
So Ajamila is realizing how fortunate he was that he could chant the holy name.
阿加米勒觉悟到他是多么的幸运，能够唱诵主的圣名。
And he could understand it was due to his past spiritual activities that before, as a young person, he'd done devotional service.
他开始觉得这是他以前在年轻的时候所从事过一些奉献服务。
So Ajamila continues describing himself. He said, I'm a very fallen person, I'm a cheater, and I've killed Brahminical culture.
阿加米勒继续说道，我是一个扼杀了婆罗门文化的无耻的骗子。
He said, I am personification of sinful life.
我是罪恶生活的化身，罪恶活动的化身。
I am nothing in comparison to the chanting of the holy name of the Lord.
我哪里有资格配唱诵主的圣名呢？
So Prabhupada,In this purport, he writes that devotees of Krishna should always remember what was our position before we came to Krishna consciousness.
圣帕帕德在这里说到，一个奉献者应该时常的记忆起， 我们在来到 Krishna 知觉之前是一种什么样的状态。
And we should remember what is our position now.
而且还应该记得我们现在的这个资格或状态又是什么样的。
Before becoming devotees, we were very sinful. We had all bad habits, meat eating, drunkard, women hunting, all kinds of sinful activities.
在我们成为奉献者之前，我们吃肉、喝酒，而且追女人，从事着各种各样的罪恶活动。
But now we've got the chance to chant Hare Krishna.
但现在我们得到了唱诵 Hare Krishna 的机会。
So we should always appreciate our good fortune.
因此，我们应该总是感激这种好运。
And for this purpose, we're trying to open more and more centers everywhere around the world.
为了这个理由，我们才不断不断地在全世界各地开设这样的中心。
To teach people to chant the holy name and to serve Krishna.
去告诉人们唱诵圣名，服务主，服务 Krishna.
And we should be very careful not to fall back again into the material life.
我们应该非常小心，不要再回到以前的物质生活的状态之中去了。
Ajaneel confesses, he said, I am such a sinful person.
Ajamila 继续说，我是一个如此罪恶之人。
But I must control my mind, I must control my life, I must use it for devotional service.
现在我有这个机会，我应该完全地控制我的心意，我的感官。
I shouldn't fall again into the darkness of ignorance of material life.
我应该始终做奉献服务，不要再堕落到物质生活的黑暗愚昧的深渊之中去了。
We all have to be very determined not to go back into Maya.
我们每一个人都应该有这样的决心，不要再堕落到 Maya 之中。
By the mercy of Krishna and the spiritual master, we have come to this position of Krishna consciousness.
通过主 Krishna 和宁信导师的仁慈，我们被提升到这样崇高的状态之中。
And we should pray that we will not again fall back into sinful life.
我们应该祈祷不要再堕落到这种罪恶的生活之中。
So Ajamil understood that he'd been identifying himself with the body and the material desires of the body for sense gratification.
Ajamil 知道以前他认同于躯体以及这种躯体的感官享乐的欲望，因此从事了很多的罪恶活动。
So the same way we have many desires and we engage in many types of sometimes pious and often impious activities.
就是认同之后会从事很多虔诚的或罪恶的活动。
So we have to be determined to get away from the material bondage of life.
因此我现在要摆脱这种物质的错觉能量的物质的束缚。
And this bondage comes about by Krishna's illusory energy, who appears in the form of a woman.
而这种物质的错觉能量的束缚是主 Krishna 是以一种女人的形式给予我们的物质的束缚。
So because of the power of this illusory energy, we become like a dancing dog.Under the control of the woman.
受错觉能量的欺骗，我变得像一条听女人指挥的跳舞的狗一样。
So we should give up all these lusty desires and get free of illusion.
我现在要摒弃一切物质享乐的欲望，摆脱这种错觉。
And we should become a friend to all the living entities. And we should be in Krishna consciousness.
我现在要成为一切众生的朋友，始终专注于 Krishna 之觉。
So to take up devotional service like this, we should also have this kind of determination.
要有 Krishna, 要从事奉献服的，对从事奉献服的人来说，都应该有这种下决心的标准。
We have to get free from Maya.
我们应该免于 Maya 的影响。
And at the same time, we should have compassion for other people suffering in Maya.
同时我们应该对其他人保持对其他那些受玛雅钳制的人对他们有怜悯之情。
Krishna consciousness is not just only for us, but it's for others also.
Krishna 知觉运动不仅是为我们自己而且是为其他人。
So if somebody only thinks about their own liberation, he's not as advanced as somebody who's trying to give mercy to others.
如果一个人他只考虑的是自己的解脱，这样的人并没有那些考虑着他人的福祉的人，并没有他们精进。
So if somebody thinks about how to spread Krishna consciousness, how to give it to others, that is the greatest mercy.
如果一个人总是想着传播 Krishna 的仁慈，想把这个给予他人的话，这是最大的仁慈。
And Prabhupada explains this, if a devotee is advanced like this, then he will never fall down because Krishna will give him special protection.
圣帕帕的在这里说，像这样进步的一个奉献者，他永远不会堕落，因为主 Krishna 会给予他特殊的保护。
Everybody is like a toy in the hands of Maya.
每一个人都像 Maya 手中的玩偶一样。
And we just move as Maya moves us.
我们总是按照 Maya 的操纵， Maya 在操纵的我们。
So we have to come to Krishna consciousness to get free from Maya and also to help to free others.
因此我们应该来到 Krishna 知觉之中，不仅为了拯救自己，也是为了帮助他人。
So we will stop here today.
OK, 我们今天讲到这里。
Are there any questions? Oh, there were some questions left over from Tuesday.
OK, Sati Mataji.
Hi Krishna.
先把星期二的这个问题说一下，您先等，您发上来。
星期二的问题，稍等啊，我
好好好，
因为我星期二不是我主持，我问一下艾米啊，艾米，哈里克什纳，您能把那个周二的问题发上来吗？
周二的问题全部问完了，没有了。
一天你告诉我有几个问题，他们都发 Guru Mani 告诉我有问题，他们说你没有给我们，
没有问题，全部问完了。
Guru,
那天你不是问他的吗？ 你问他就是说还有问题，后来他说我说过的就是问题到此结束，后面没有问题了，我就没有把它保存了。
对，周二那天后来就是说到时间以后就没有人再提问题了，
对的，
当时提上来
的
问题都已经回答过了，是我看到了，想起来
OK 我听错了。
好，那 Good Day 我们今天有问题提上来了。
好，第一个问题来自于 S1，顶拜孤乳翻译和所有的奉献者，请问一，超然的宗教是奉献服务，一般的宗教是指佛教、道教等物质的宗教吗？二，库鲁之野是举行宗教仪式的地方，有哪些宗教仪式？Obeisance to Guru, I want to ask first, the transcendental religion means the devotional service and the normal religion.That means the Buddhism, Taoism, or other material religion?
Well, you have to examine the motivation of the people who participate in these other religions.
你得检测他们在从事这些宗教的，在从事这些宗教的他们的动机是什么。
Now some people, they may be practicing their religion for material purposes.
有一些人从事宗教的活动，或许是为了物质的动机。
And some other people, they may be very transcendental.
或者有一些人。其他的人他们在从事宗教活动的时候很超人。
So it's not just the name, oh, all of these people are material religion. You have to examine their consciousness.
我们不要根据名字去定义这一群人，比如说这一群人就是一个物质的，或者说超人的，或怎么样。我们要检测他们的动机。
Srimad Bhagavatam talks about Srimad Bhagavatam talks about cheating religion, Kaitava Dharma.
圣典博迦瓦坛讲述了欺骗的宗教 Kaitava Dharma.
Cheating religion, just like if you come before the deity and you tell the deity, oh, I love you, I and you want to offer everything to the deity, and but you're thinking all the time.Where's the money? Or give me, fulfill my desires. Then that's cheating.
比如说有人去见神像，他去见神像，哦，我非常爱你神像，然后他也准备很多的供奉的这些东西给神像，但是呢，他满脑子想的是，我的钱在哪里，如何能满足我内心的各种物质欲望。那么这样的宗教，这样的形式就是一种欺骗式的宗教。
So we make a show of feeling of love for the for the deity or for God, but our real purpose is to get something. It's a business transaction.
我们或许展示了我们对神像的爱，但是呢，我们真正的动机和目的是一种生意，是想从神像那里得到一些别的，那是一种生意。
So Prabhupada taught us devotional service, pure religion means to finish up our business, not to do business, but to simply offer everything with love, without anything, without demand for anything in return.
圣帕帕德说，我们超然的这个宗教是指的。终止这种生意和交易，向神像供奉一切，向神供奉一切，怀着爱心供奉一切，但是并不渴求从神那里获得什么。
So pure transcendental religion is described in Srimad Bhagavatam.Savaipum sam paro dharmo yato bhaktir adhoksaje ahaitaki apratiyata yayatma supresidati. That the supreme occupation for all mankind is loving service to the Lord, which is without motivation and is uninterrupted.
圣典博迦瓦坛描述了超然的纯洁的宗教是怀着爱心的奉献服务。没有终止的和没有其他物质动机的服务，不间断的没有其他动机的奉献服务。
Right. So that is transcendental religion when it's unmotivated and uninterrupted.
这就是超然的宗教。当这个活动是。没有其他物质动机的，以及不被终止、不被间断的这样的活动，就是超然的、纯洁的宗教。
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The second this devotee asked, the Kurukshetra is the place to hold the religion rites. So, what are the religion activities?
Well, when Krishna went to Kurukshetra, it was not Kali Yuga, it was still Dwapara Yuga. So Lord Krishna went there and they performed different religious sacrifices.
当主 Krishna 去到 Kurukshetra 的时候，那个时候还不是 Kali 年代，还是 Dwapara 年代。所以主 Krishna 去到 Kurukshetra 的时候，做了很多的祭祀活动。
There were qualified brahmanas there to chant mantras.
那里有很多有资格的婆罗门在那里唱诵伟大的唱诵 mantra 曼陀罗。
But today, if you go to a holy place.And you want to do a sacrifice, you should do the chanting of the holy name.
但是在今天，如果你去到圣地的话，你不是做祭祀活动，而是唱诵主的圣名。
And it's also proper to give charity when you go to the holy place.
同时，你去到圣地，你也可以去给予布施。
Give charity to the brahmanas and to the holy place.
给予布施给那些婆罗门和圣地。
Yes.
Yes. Next question from Yuna. She said with English, "I, Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, and the devotees, please accept my humble obeisances, O Lord, to Srila Prabhupada. Is this only one case with Ajamila when the Yamadutas wanted to take the wrong person?Or were there any other cases when they were wrong? Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru. 他这里问到就是说，是不是只有阿迦米勒这一个例子，就是 Yamadutta 带把这个带了带错了人，抓错了人，抓到这个 Yamaraj 那去，还是说还有其他的例子
？We don't know of any other.
我们不知道是否有其他的例子。
Yes, we're only told about Ajamila. I don't know any other incident where it happened.
我只知道阿加米勒的这个情况，我还不知道是否在其他有没有发生这样的情况。Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Hare Krishna.顶拜咕噜感恩翻译，请问有人对奉爱瑜伽好奇，想来参加联谊，请问对好奇的人，我们应该如何向他传教，达到一种比较好的效果？ A basis to guru, I want to ask, when somebody are very curious about the bhakti yoga and he want to join our association, I want to ask, how should we?Preach to these kind of people, and then can be a better way.
Well, we should introduce them to how to chant the Maha Mantra, and teach them how to chant Hare Krishna.
嗯，我们应该告诉他们唱诵 Hare Krishna 如何唱诵 Hare Krishna 曼陀罗。
And we should teach them the basic philosophy that we're not the body.And we have to control the mind and senses.
我们得告诉他，我们不是这个躯体，我们应该控制心意和感官。一些基础的哲学。Gurudev, I think this devotee asked, for the curious people, there any other unique way or to preach?
Well, they're curious. They must have a lot of questions.So let them ask the questions and answer all the questions.
对于好奇的人，他们一定有很多的问题，那就让他们问很多的问题，然后我们回答他们的问题。
What are they curious about? Let them tell. What do they find curious? And then we will explain what we're doing.
他们到底好奇什么呢？我们就解释给他们什么。他们好奇的地方，我们就给他们解释我们在所从事的是什么。 next question.
Mm-hmm.
Next question from 静心瑜伽，顶拜孤儿以及所有的奉献者，圣帕帕德说他个人不相信占星，那占星到底有用没用呢？他对我们的奉献服务有帮助吗？请孤儿给予教导，顶拜您的莲花组。A basis to guru and all devotees, Srila Prabhupada said, he personally not trust the astrology. So I want to ask whether the astrology are benefit or not, are useful or not useful. What kind of help the astrologers can give us for our devotional service?
Well,astrology is a Vedic science.
占星是伟大的科学。
Dealing with material situations in the material world, material body.
它处理的是物质的状态，物质的躯体。
So if you're very transcendental, if you're really fixed in pure devotional service, then astrology is not so important.
如果你非常的超然，专注于奉爱服的话，占星不是很重要。
But like most of us, we're not so transcendental, and the Vedic science is a very helpful indication.
对于我们大多数人来讲，我们不是那么的超然，所以伟达的这个科学有时候是一种提示，一种预测。
We can understand a lot about compatibility between one person and another from the Vedic science.
我们可以从中了解到很多的关于人和人之间是否可以匹配，就是从这个占星的一些真相。
And you can see here Prabhupada said, of course, if they're devotees, it's not so important. But we do see that devotees, often they get married, they have difficulty, they don't get along with each other.
Shen Prabhupada 在这个要旨里面说，奉献者不必很在意这个占星，但是我们也看到很多的奉献者在一起，他们并不长久。
And we have seen couples marry, and the compatibility was very good astrologically, but still their marriage ended in disaster.
我们也看到这样的例子，有一些人他们的占星说两个人在一起非常的相合相匹配，但是他们的婚姻在一起又好像看上去是一场灾难。
So it's hard to know.But there's no harm in checking the astrology.
因此非常难以很难以说通过这种占星我们能知道一些什么。
The problem is astrologers today, that they may not be so accurate.
Accurate
means they're not so good, they're not so...They can't tell you exactly what will happen.
现在的这个情况是，或许当今的很多占星师他并不是那么的好，那么的准确告诉你到底会发生一些什么。
And sometimes however, it's good if you're going to go to astrology, you want to hear it from a devotee.You should find a devotee astrologer, not just some karmi astrologer.
如果你想找一个占星的话，你应该找一个奉献者占星，而不是一个物质主义者的占星者。
So there are some astrologers within our Krishna consciousness movement, some devotees who do this.
在我们的 Krishna 知觉，有一些奉献者在做这个占星。
And Prabhupada also.Sometimes, I know when Prabhupada was sick, Prabhupada would have devotees go to astrologers and find out what the astrologers said.
我知道的是圣帕帕德生病的时候，他也让一个奉献者去看了一下，到底这个占星师会说一些什么。
He just wanted to see what they would say. He didn't follow, but he just wanted to know what are they saying.
他并不是说要去遵循这个占星师所说的什么，他只是想了解这个占星师说了什么。
So the point is, astrology is not 100%. That's it's not going to tell you everything.
我们所说的这些事情的要点是，首先占星不会告诉你100%的准确的所有的这些事情，不会完全的给你帮助。
But sometimes it's a good guide to help.
但有时它会给你一些指导，一些好的指导。
Particularly when it comes to something like marriage.
特别是比如说婚姻的这个方面的时候。
Because marriage, we have to understand, marriage is not always such a spiritual affair.There's a lot of material dealings involved.
因为我们要了解的是，婚姻其实不是一个灵性的事情，大多数时候是一个物质的事物。
So the astrology can give us some indication.
因此，占星可以给予我们一些建议和指导。
So no harm to check with the astrologers.
因此，向占星去询问没有坏处。
There was one girl in Hong Kong, and she got married to a man from China. Before their marriage, they checked the horoscope, and the astrologer told them, said, "Oh, very good." He said, "You have very nice. You he said you should have children. You may have about 4 children."
有一个香港的女士嫁给了一个中国的奉献者，然后就是咱们这边的奉献者。当时这个占星说你们非常好，会有四个孩子。
And so they got married, they had 2 children.
但是他们结婚之后有两个孩子。
And they get along very well together. The marriage is very nice, no problem.
他们在一起非常好的相处，没有非常好。
And there was another girl from China. She married a devotee from. There was this one devotee. He was a European devotee, and he was living in Vrindavan. And he met this Chinese girl, and they got married. And before they married, they checked the astrology chart.
还有一个中国的女士嫁给一个欧洲的人，他现在稳达稳，在他们结婚之前，他们也看了这个占星的表。
Because the man was quite a bit older than the girl.
因为这个男士要比女士要大很多。
But when they checked the astrology chart, the astrologer said, "Oh, you have at least 20 years together."
但是他们看了这个表之后，他说，你们至少还有20年在一起的这个时间。
And so they have 2 children, and they're together, and they're happy, and marriage is nice.
因此他们有了两个孩子，然后结婚之后也关系非常好，也关系不错。
However, we have seen marriages where it looked like the astrology charts were very good, and the marriage failed.
当然还有一种情况，我们看了这些图表之后非常好，但是这个婚姻却失败了。
So it's not, you can't just go only by astrology.
所以占星不是百分之百的，我们不能完全只靠占星。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from, Huawei. 主 Chaitanya 喜欢 Prahlada 的故事，为什么？ Why the Lord Chaitanya like to hear the Prahlada Maharaj's pastime?
Because Prahlad is a Prema Bhakti, he has such deep love for Krishna.
因为 Prahlad Maharaj 是一个纯粹的奉献者，他对 Krishna 有非常深的爱。
It's very pleasing to hear about a devotee and about how much he's suffering on behalf of devotional service just because he's a devotee.
Sorry, Gurudev.
It's very nice to hear about how Prahlad tolerates so many difficulties in the course of devotional service.
Next question from Vaishnava Vani. Ajahn Mila chanting is not offensive, and so he got liberated. Is our chanting still offense? So we are not able to achieve the same result. Ajahn Mila 的唱诵是没有冒犯的，因此他获得解脱。如果我们的唱诵仍是冒犯的，是不是我们不能达到同样的效果？
Ajahn Mila's chanting was at the level of Namabhas, the intermediate level. It was not pure chanting and it was not offensive.
Ajahn Mila 的唱诵是 Namabhas, 它是处于中间阶段，既不是冒犯的，也不是纯粹的唱诵。
So the result of that kind of chanting is he destroyed sinful reactions. He became freed of his past sins.
他唱诵这样的这个，他在这种层面上唱诵的结果是，他免除了所有的罪恶活动。
And that resulted in his life being extended.
Sorry.
He got a longer life.
Okay. 他然后得到一个更长的生命。
And he was able to go away, live his. He could understand also his situation. He could realize how he was in a lot of Maya, and so he got out of that Maya.
而且他开始意识到他到底从事。就是他以前从事了很多罪恶，以及现在的状况，他现在想要摆脱这种玛雅的情况。
We will hear in the rest of the chapter how Ajahn Mila ultimately got delivered. He was able to go back to Godhead.
我们将会在后面听到阿迦米勒是如何回归守神的。
So.For our situation, we're still on the path. Our chanting, sometimes it may be offensive, sometimes it may be intermediate level.
而我们的状态是，有些时候在冒犯之中的念诵，有些时候是在中间状态之中的念诵，就是没有冒犯的念诵。
So we have to try to improve the quality of our chanting.
因此我们应该提高我们唱诵的品质。
Our main offense in chanting is inattentive chanting.
让我们的冒犯的念诵变成一种很专注的念诵。
So we want to try to concentrate on the holy name, to hear the holy name.
我们应该试着专注的聆听圣名。
So more chanting. We have to develop taste for the name. Means more chanting.
为了发展出圣名的品味，我们应该更多的唱诵。
And we have to take care to avoid the modes of passion and ignorance.
而且我们应该小心，不要就是涉及到激情和愚昧形态之中去。
Be careful of lust, anger, and greed.
然后要小心色欲、愤怒和贪婪。
And try to be a surrendered devotee.
尝试着成为一个臣服的奉献者。
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This question from Tom. Hare Krishna 顶拜孤儿的莲花族，您能再解释一下为什么传播 Krishna 之觉比其他的奉爱服务更重要？ Hare Krishna obeisance to your lotus feet. Can you explain more why the spread Krishna consciousness are much more important than any other devotional service?
Because it's so difficult.
因为这是更难的。
It's the most difficult, the most challenging thing to do.
因为这是最难而且最具有挑战性的。
Just like Srila Prabhupada went to America alone, with no money,
就像
didn't know anybody.
就像圣帕巴德去到美国的时候，他没有钱，也不认识任何人。
Could you imagine going to another country?And you're a foreigner, and you don't know anybody, you're going to go there and try to spread Krishna consciousness.
你能想象一下，比如说你自己去到一个陌生的地方，一个另外一个国家，你不知道任何人，你完全都不知道的情况下，你要去传播 Krishna 知觉。
Most people, they're terrified, they're afraid.
大多数的人都会感到害怕。
Even if they go to another city, to leave their own city and go to another city in the same country, they find it very difficult.
即便一个人去到一个国，就是说在他自己的国家去到另外一个城市去做这样的事情，对于他来说都是很难的。
You go to a strange town, you don't know the people, you have to start from nowhere, you don't know anyone. So it's not easy, there are many difficulties.
就像你去到一个陌生的城郊，一个城镇，你在那里不知道任何人，你不知道如何下，从何开始，你什么都不知道。
So it certainly is the most difficult of services.
这很确定的，这是非常困难的一件事情。
You know, people can do austerities, they can go and perform tapasyas and austerities. They can go and sit in a cave or go to the forest and be alone.But it's much more difficult to go and try to spread Krishna consciousness.
人们可以做苦行，在一个山洞里面就那么一个人的待着，但是比这个更苦的，比这个更难的事情就是去传播 Krishna 知觉。
Because people may not trust you, you may be.So many people may be your enemy, they may not like you, they may challenge you and hate you. Why you have come here? Why you're telling all like this? This is not our philosophy. This is not our teachings.
因为在这样的情况下，你去的话，人们或许会不喜欢你，而且还会讨厌你。而且还会成为你的敌人。你为什么要来到这里？你为什么要传播这个东西？这个东西跟我们以前的文化又不一样。他们会挑战你，等等这些。
Yeah.
Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Gopinath Priya. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru Day 的莲花族，请问。我带我的弟弟去西安联谊的地方了，他们欣赏我们的哲学思想，对奉献者印象不错，但是他不相信 Krishna， 更不理解大家跪拜 Krishna， 我应该做一点什么事情呢？我可以告诉他我们的父母从事的很多的罪恶活动吗？Hare Krishna, obeisance to Guru's lotus feet. I take my brother to Xi'an City and association with devotees. He's very appreciate our philosophy. and have a good impression with the devotees, but he didn't trust Krishna and not understand why we bow obeisance to Krishna. So what should I do? Can I told him our parents do a lot of sinful activities?
Well, in America also sometimes people objected. They didn't like to bow down. They didn't like to offer obeisances.
在美国也有很多人他并不喜欢跪拜，也不喜欢就是顶拜。
So Prabhupada would tell them that you may not like to bow down to Krishna, but you have to bow down to old age, you bow down to disease, and you bow down to death. You're forced to bow down to these things.
圣帕帕德就给他们说, 你或许不喜欢向Krishna顶拜, 但是你得向生老病死, 向这些事情顶拜, 你不得不向他们顶拜。
Devotees are happy to bow down to Krishna, and by bowing down to Krishna means they no longer have to bow down to old age, disease, and death.
奉献者非常乐于向主Krishna顶拜, 因为他如果向Krishna顶拜的话, 他不用再一次向生老病死顶拜了。
So you said your brother liked the philosophy. I don't know why he doesn't like bowing down to Krishna. That's also part of our philosophy.
你说你的弟弟很喜欢我们的哲学, 但是我不知道他为什么不喜欢顶拜。 这也是我们的这个哲学思想中的一部分。
It's mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita, the most confidential knowledge. One of the, there are four things mentioned, and one of them is to offer obeisances to Krishna.
这个在《薄伽梵歌》中最机密的知识部分也谈到了，有四个活动，其中一个是向我顶礼。
So as far as your parents doing sinful activities, I don't think you want to bring that up.
关于你父母所从事的这些罪恶活动，我并不觉得你应该提起来。
And just encourage your brother to read the book and understand the philosophy and think again about offering obeisances.
然后就让你的兄弟、你的弟弟去看我们的这个书，阅读我们的书，然后了解我们的哲学，再去想一想这个顶拜这个事情。
He doesn't have to bow down with the whole body. He can bow down in his mind, or he can just simply bow down verbally by offering respects verbally.
他可以并不用全，就是无体，就是这种顶拜或跪拜的这种形式，也他可以这种心意上的或者口头上的这种尊敬，也是很好的。
But it's very good. You took your brother to the center and you introduced him to Krishna consciousness. Very good.
但是你把你的弟弟带到我们的这个中心，这是一个很好的事情。
And I hope he got, I'm sure he got some nice prasadam there.
我希望你们在那里吃到了很好吃的prasadam.
We have a very nice cook there. Chin Prabhu is. Very good cook.
我们在那里有很好的厨师，阿秋的Prabhu。
No, Chen, Bhakta Chen.
Ah, Bhakta Chen. Chen Prabhu. Next question from Shyamalata Devidasi. 顶拜亲爱的Gurudev, 请接受我卑微的顶拜，顶拜你莲花祖。 请问通过占星术, 能知道已故的人去到哪个星宿吗? Obeisance to Guru's Lord's Feet. I want to ask, through the astrology, can we know the passed away people, where they go, which planet they go.
Which planet they go?
Yeah.
Hmm. You want to know that?
你想知道这个吗？
Well, Bhagavad Gita tells us, if they die in the mode of goodness, they'll go to higher planets. If they die in the mode of passion, they'll come back here. And if they die in the mode of ignorance, they'll go down to hellish planets.
薄伽梵歌已经告诉我们了，如果他在善良形态中离开躯体的，他可以去到天堂；畸形形态中的会再次回到这里；如果在愚昧形态中离开躯体的，他会去到地狱。
Astrology can tell these kind of things. Some astrologers may do this, but it's not very common.
有一部分占星人或许可以告诉你这些，但是这个并不是普遍的。
Just like there was one big politician in India, and he was a big politician, but he was very materialistic, and he was actually not very pious, not very religious.
就像在印度有一个政治家，他是一个很物质主义者的人，他不是那么的虔诚。
So after he died, an astrologer did some calculation. He predicted that he has now become a dog in Sweden.
当他离开躯体之后，有一个占星家就说，他说这个人，这个死去的政治家，现在在瑞士做了一条狗。
不是瑞士，瑞典。
瑞典。
Sweden.
Sweden.
Yeah.
Sweden, 在瑞典，
瑞典
做了一条狗。
So, yeah, some astrologers, they predict these things. It's not, yeah. We want to save people from going to these hellish planets.
我们应该帮助人们，帮助人们，拯救人们从这个地狱的状况之中，拯救人们。
Okay, any more question?
Yes, one more question, I think. 请问 Guru, 阿加米勒、帕拉德、朱瓦马哈拉吉、帕拉德、纳拉的前身都做萨达纳吗？感恩 Guru. I want to ask Guru Maharaj, Guru,Ajamila, Prahlad Maharaj, Dhruva Maharaj, Narada, their past life, are they Yudha Sadhana Bhakti?
And their past life?
Yes.
Well, Narada did sadhana in his past life.
Narada 是做过 sadhana 的。
After he stayed with the Bhaktivedantas,He was the son of a maidservant woman, and he was serving the Bhaktivedantas, and so he learned sadhana from them.
他是从这个 Bhaktivedanta 的那些权威那里学习的，然后学习的这个 sadhana.
And so after they left, and then his mother died, then he was all alone, and he went traveled, and he did sadhana, he meditated.
当这些巴克提维丹塔权威们离开的时候，他的母亲离开了躯体，他一个人，然后做了萨达纳，也开始了旅行。
And Dhruva Maharaj, he met Narada Muni when he was going to the forest, and Narada Muni told him how to do sadhana.
当 Dhruva Maharaj 遇到 Narada Muni 的时候，Dhruva Maharaj 准备去这个森林里面苦行，然后他也做了萨达纳。
And for 6 months he did sadhana in the forest, and then after 6 months God appeared to him. He saw the Supreme Lord.
在森林里面做了六个月的苦行和就是 sadhana 之后，他见到了主。
And Prahlad Maharaj, he did his sadhana in the womb. He was hearing. He was in the womb of his mother, but he was hearing from Narada Muni.
关于 Prahlad Maharaj， 他是在母亲的子宫里面做了 Sadhana Bhakti， 他在他的母亲的子宫里面聆听，他从事了聆听这个服务，是他从 Narada Muni 那里聆听。
And after he took birth, then he was in the Gurukula with all the dim, and he was doing sadhana. He was preaching. He was teaching the other boys to worship Krishna.
当他从母亲的子宫里出来，他去到了 Gurukula 的时候，这个时候他在教学，他向其他的男孩，他向其他的男孩们传教。
And Ajamila, he was born in a Brahmana family, so as a young Brahmana boy, he was doing sadhana.
阿加米勒 他在一个婆罗门的家庭中出生，当他 出生之后，他也做了 sadhana， 婆罗门的这个 sadhana。
To take birth in a Brahmana family, he must have done a lot of pious activities in the past life before that.
他在一个婆罗门的家庭出生，那么他在之前的这一生之中一定做过很多的虔诚活动。
Yeah, so sadhana is very important.
是的，规范修习 sadhana 是很重要的。
And Prabhupada did a lot of sadhana as well before he went to America.
在圣帕帕德去美国之前，他也做了很多的 sadhana。
Prabhupada did his sadhana as a householder. He was married with family, but he was doing sadhana.
圣帕帕德在他的居士生活之中做了很多的规范 sadhana 规范修习。
And later,
他结婚了，但是他做了很多的 sadhana.
Then later on, his vanaprastha, he was doing sadhana.
之后他过着 vanaprastha 的生活，他也做了很多的 sadhana.
Then he went to America, his sannyasi, he was also doing sadhana.
然后他去了美国，他在 sannyasi 的这个层面也做了很多的 sadhana.
He was sleeping only 2 hours a night. He was waking up very in the middle of the night to write his books. That was his sadhana.
他晚上只睡2个小时，他在半夜的时候醒来写书，这就是他的 sadhana.
He was also chanting, of course, and he was giving classes.
他既唱诵，而且还讲课。
He was training devotees.
而且他还训练奉献者。
That's all part of sadhana.
这些都是 sadhana.
Okay.
Okay.
No more questions?
Yes.
好，感谢苏布里拉给我们正太的翻译，感谢萨蒂主持，感谢所有的奉献者聆听，所以我们祝福你们，唱诵并快乐，
唱诵并快乐，是不是？三个，
不对，嗯，珍珍又提了一个问题上来，
哦，珍珍，
你还可以有时间吗？
啊，可以。
Hare Krishna, 亲爱的 Gurudev, 请接受我卑微的顶拜，顶拜您的莲花足。我怎么样可以一直保持宁静的喜乐？工作的时候很容易就把 Krishna 给忘记了，工作中却有很多的碎片时间，容易陷入胡思乱想的状态。请问 Guru 我该怎么做 ？Hare Krishna, my dear Gurudev, obeisances to you. How can I?Maintain the spiritual bliss. When I work, it's very easy to forget Krishna, and there are a lot of small time. Sometimes I'm very easy to fall in a lot of mixed mind. My mind will fly a lot at many places.So how can I do?
You have to do more sadhana. Every morning you have to wake up and do your sadhana, do your chanting and reading before you go to work. And gradually your mind will become more controlled.
你应该做更多的 sadhana 规范休息，每天早上起来好的念诵，然后你再去工作， 过一段时间之后，你的心意、你的思想就会得到控制。
You have to be patient. You're a new devotee. You haven't been doing sadhana very long. It's going to take some more time. But just keep practicing, keep doing sadhana, and gradually your mind will become more peaceful and you'll become more calm and relaxed and you'll do better.
你是一个新的奉献者，做 sadhana 规范休息的时间并不长，因此你要耐心。当你持续做一段时间之后，你的心会平静下来，然后越来越平和，然后越来越放松下来。
So, don't worry. Krishna's with you.
不用担心。
Krishna's with you. Krishna will help you and give you intelligence, how to improve, how to advance.
Krishna 会和你在一起。Krishna 会帮助你。Krishna 会逐渐的让你越来越精进。
You're doing well. You're doing nicely.
你做得很好。
Just have to keep going, maintain your chanting, keep up your devotion, your standard, the principles.
只需要继续保持这样做，然后维持这些原则，奉外服的原则。
Okay. So we'll stop here now. Now Tuesday is Nrisimha Chaturthi Sati.Are we going to have a regular class?
可以啊。
我们就是说星期二是不是还要继续讲课呢，萨蒂玛？
对呀，是啊，是的，我们可早上可以正常。Good day， 您可以安排主尼夏哈 Dev 的这个消失光吗？还是？
继续讲，可以讲一些那是一个小游戏吧，
是的，我觉得是挺好。
OK Hare Bol.
So big
Hare Krishna.
Thank you very much Guru Maharaj.
Hare Krishna.
And please take care and business to you.
Hare Krishna. 你也多保重，注意身体。
Hare Krishna.